Yes, the present is rich with inheritances from the past. To see them, we must look with interest and with knowledge. Knowledge itself is an inheritance from the past. Knowledge comes to us through the wisdom we take from other persons who are living or who have lived. Knowledge today is passed on from one to another, much as wise men thousands of years ago gave knowledge to the children of their tribes. And as in ancient Greece, when philosophy reached great heights in the teachings of Socrates and Plato and Aristotle. In our first universities, founded in the Middle Ages, and in our modern classes and schools, knowledge is still given by word of mouth. Over this same period of time, another method of transmitting knowledge developed. When we look at someone writing, we can see our inheritance from medieval times, when men inscribed the wisdom of the past for the people of the present and future. And we can see further our inheritance from Egyptian hieroglyphics and other ancient writing, such as cuneiform. Printing had its beginnings in ancient China. Then, as printing presses were developed and improved, knowledge was made available to all people who could read intelligently. So it is that today the wisdom of yesterday is open to all of us. Once more, let's look about and see the past mingling with the present. Sometimes it isn't easy to see the contributions of the past. Where can we see them in this modern building? We must look through the eyes of history. Look for the post and lintel that came from ancient Egypt. Look for the Greek concept of form and symmetry. Look for the arches and vaults used by the Romans 2,000 years ago. Look for building materials that have come from science and research that began in the Middle Ages and continues today. And look for mathematics and mathematical expressions. This came to us from the Hindu people, through the Arabians who carried it across North Africa, into Spain and Europe, where it was adopted by the Western world. Yes, all this and more lies behind a modern building. You can find it if you look with interest and knowledge. Wherever you look at the present, you can see the past. In this church, you can see a great religious tradition and way of life. In modern commerce, you can find customs and systems of trade more than 2,000 years old. In the city itself, you can see patterns of living that have been developing for centuries, from the times of nomadic tribes and people. Yes, in the city and in the country, you can find parts of our inheritance from the past. What we do with it, what we add to it, will be important to the future. For remember, future generations will count our contributions in their inheritance from the past.